have patients who have been drinking 5 glasses of lime juice after testing COVID positive with lots of chest infection. So, Gadia.
Hi.
You look fabulous on screen, off screen, virtually, every time. You just look so fab.
Thank you, as do you. And you're in my favorite, one of my favorite places in the world, in Goa.
It's a lovely place. It's indeed a lovely place, lovely people. And I just love Goa. So, Diya, as you know, that today we are going to talk about COVID nutrition. And as of now, people have been taking care of their immunity, trying not to get COVID. But all those who are COVID positive are really confused. And as a nutritionist, I have launched a lot of COVID nutrition plans and stuff for people to understand that what exactly they should eat and what exactly they should not eat. So that's what I'm going to share a few points out here with you today.
Sure, okay. I'm looking forward to this.
Yeah, so with COVID nutrition, first thing is the symptoms, because people need to know, the patient needs to know what the symptoms are, whether they are having cough, cold, chest congestion, you know, fever. Based on that is what they need to have, and based on that what they require to eat. Now people start drinking like lime juices, orange juices, a lot of decoctions, okay, which is definitely good for immunity because they're good in vitamin C. But what about people who are already having sore throat, phlegm? Okay, they are somewhere messing themselves up. I have patients who have been drinking 5 glasses of lime juice after testing COVID positive with lots of chest infection, which has messed their system up. Secondly, they are having decoctions. Now, decoctions means they are having either tulsi water, pepper water, or haldi milk. Again, excellent. Indian herbs and spices are very good. But now those are contributing with the blood thinners what they're having, the steroids what they're having. So first thing I would tell to all my COVID positive patients, listen, be positive. You're going to get out of this. And two is, do not overdo anything without your medical practitioner or your doctor or your nutritionist knowing about it when you have already tested COVID positive. So don't try, you're not a guinea pig, don't try any of these big precautions and stuff like whatever is there on WhatsApp and Google. So don't do that. Take care of your protein content, which is very important in healing. We all know protein is such an important nutrient.
Ask you this, that I'm vegetarian. I was vegan for over 2 years and I've just about started having some dairy products. But I know a lot of people who are recovering from COVID who have been told categorically by their doctors that they have to start eating meat. But what about
They have to eat a protein basically, and a protein in a good form. So if you're taking protein in form of kala chana soup, which is an excellent soup for vegans, right? So they just need to soak the kala chana, boil it next day, have that water twice a day. That's going to take care of the protein content. Dal broth, then in the soups, they can add about a spoonful of dal. They can have some kind of dips made with protein like hummus, which is homemade, but with, of course with less oil. And they could do egg whites. Anybody who's eating non-vegetarian food, egg whites is a very good thing. And for some time of period, if you're with your clinical practitioner, with your nutritionist, then you have to supplement your protein through a supplement form, not the whey protein. We're not talking about whey protein here. We're talking about protein which is used for the therapeutic healings, which we use for a lot of burn patients and cancer patients as well. So some grams of protein, but yes, under supervision, because we also need to keep checking on the kidney function and the liver function, you know, that's very important. So protein is very important for healing. Antioxidants. Now, antioxidants, water is first thing. So hydrate yourself enough. And two is vegetables.
In warm water help?
Yes, warm water, hot water is helping a lot, especially in North India where the weather temperature is really dipping. Yeah. And vegetables, I would prefer it in a form which is like a cooked form, instead of having like a vegetable juice. Vegetable soup is a better option. Instead of salads, sorted vegetables is a better option. And even vegetables, you know, you could grate it and put it in atta. So antioxidants. Thirdly is fruits in form of antioxidants. Now, sour fruits should be completely avoided. Anything which is orange or kino, which is there in North India right now, or even kiwi. But if you're taking apple or pear in a stewed form, that does wonders. So these are very small practical tips which a COVID positive patient can use it at home. And they can see a great, great change in themselves. Now, also, when we're talking about this, I would like to talk about immunity. Certain things one should not do to spoil, weaken their immunity. People are doing a lot of things to strengthen their immunity, healthy milk and stuff like that. But processed food, not moving, that's, you know, you're sitting is new smoking. So stay active and go off alcohol and smoking, or have it in a restricted form. Don't have it like in a binge form. And mindfully, if you're doing everything, even you're losing weight by doing it in a right way, by not skipping any food groups, that's also going to help great ways of the immunity.
I've learned a lot from you. Thank you so much for having this conversation with me. I hope many people benefit from the knowledge that you're sharing. And I think it's important to understand that nutrition is key in regaining health and, you know, keeping, maintaining health. So thank you.
Thank you so much.
I'm actually signing this mug with a little message for you.
How sweet.
As a token of love and a memory of this conversation, and I look forward to seeing you someday.
Yes, surely. See you. Bye-bye. Nice meeting you, and nice meeting you virtually, though, but nice meeting you.
Same here. Thank you.